How was your week?
How was my week?
Weekend?
My weekend? My week was
awesome.
Was your
week good?
It was a good week. It really was. Saw a lot of friends. My parents came into town. My dad saw my place for the first time, and I've had it since like December, so that was really cool. And but I will say, he gets there. He's there for like 15 minutes. He's like, he likes plants, you know, like in the house. And he's like, hey, what do you think if I like bought some plastic plants? I'm like, like I'm not like super down, but you can buy them if you want. Like he's like, psh. Anyways, dude, goes out, buys all these plastic plants, bro. This freaking big, huge one. When I saw it, my mom was there, and she started laughing. I started laughing. I was like, this has got to be a joke, like. I don't know. Anyways, so those probably won't last in my place, but it was really cool to have them. Weather was good. Corey, our track guy, killed it on the track this week, so it's been good.
Figure that whole group did good.
Our group did good?
Dude, that group did good on the track. Like, this group down here freaking killed it. That place looked good.
Yeah. Yeah. Cool. All right. 2019 Florida National, absolutely brutal. Probably the hardest race of the year. But I was very, very impressed with my fitness today. And stoked just to get out front from the beginning and didn't have to fight with a lot of roost. And the pace up there is gnarly, but I was able to kind of maintain some energy through each moto and just be there at the end and still have something. So, man, as I'm like hearing about the stories of like some of the other guys like not being able to finish or not racing the second moto, like I'm super proud of my fitness. And so I think I went 3-5 on the day, two motos in the top five. I'm pretty content. But especially for how gnarly the track was.
From what I heard, I don't think Cameron McAdoo even remembers today after the first moto.
Dude, I love Cameron McAdoo. I have a lot of love for that kid. And
he's a beast.
He is a beast, man. And last weekend, dude, to get seventh, like right out off the couch, like impressive. And so throwing him to this one, like it's another beast. And so, I hope he's all right. I hope he's doing good. I'm stoked. Second moto, end of the moto, I had Alex Martin freaking pushing me. This guy just gets some energy from somewhere.
Troll power.
Bro, insane. And he is pushing me, and I'm like, I do not want to get passed by this guy. Bro, my lap times, like, at the end of the moto, second moto, were, like, close, if not a little bit faster than the beginning of the second moto. Like, that's insane.
This dude's pulling off.
That's insane, bro. And, like, I feel bad. Like, my neck's sore, my lower back's sore, like... But I'm actually, like, relatively okay. Like, I'm here, I'm wearing pants. Like, it's crazy, man. It's crazy. I'm surprised.
So, what is our fun fact of the day, though?
All right, so the fun fact of the day... I overheard two, but the best one, I'd say, Jason Anderson... When he was in eighth grade, in I think he's from New Mexico, went to state finals or like went to state in the spelling bee.
No way.
And lost on the word volcanoes. Fun fact of the day.
Should we ask him how to spell that and how was your weekend?
I don't know. I think he's. I don't know. We talked about it earlier. Zach spelled it straight, but it was he had a problem with ES or volcano just with an S, and so. He said that he wasn't allowed to ask for definition and all this stuff, which, like, obviously
sounds like
that's...
a janking spell.
Exactly, exactly. Like, you gotta have the definition, you know, like, oh, where does it originate from? Like, all this stuff. You're gonna be, like, a legit speller, so.
Thank you for your time.
Thank you.
So, how was it?
Weekend was great. Qualified first overall, first one in my career, and it's special to do it here just because I had lived here for 3 months and back in 2016, and I know the owner very well, so it's his first national, and to get it done here is special for me and him. So besides that, just kept it together for two motos. It was pretty miserable out there. The heat is unreal, and just had to, you know, refuel in between motos and just make sure you're hydrated enough to go out there and give it your best for the second moto. That was important. So felt like I conserved myself a little bit for the second moto, and I was able to, you know, give it a good shot for the second one, and was able to get the overall. So first one for me, I can't put it into words. I was thinking so much about it, even on the line, but even the last couple laps, it was hard to ride. Emotions were rolling through my head, and just had to contain them and finish it out. It was a hot one. It was gnarly.
I will say, I confused the owner for a minute, thinking it might have been your pops. He was so freaking excited.
Yeah, I mean, that's the kind of relationship we have. He was so good to me when I lived here, and I rode this track probably like every day. So training for Loretta's back then, but yeah, to do it here at his first national is so special, and looking to keep the ball rolling. It was good to rebound like this after a tough weekend last weekend, and back on the right track.
That's one. Star Team's been SoCal based for last I think 2 years about now, doing it all. How was it coming to the first humid round?
Yeah, we're pretty organized back in California, so I think it's working. We just have a good solid weeks there, so the travel's a little bit rough, so yeah, I think we proved it. We're 1-2 this weekend, so nothing wrong with what we're doing. I think it's working, so yeah, just looking to keep the momentum rolling now.
Sun's there. There we go. Now I can see it. How was your weekend?
It was pretty good. It was a tough track, obviously, with the heat and everything. It was pretty gnarly. I didn't feel the best all day. I didn't really gel with the track too well, and those guys were riding great. So after the first moto, man, I got a terrible start. I think I was almost last in the first turn, and wasted a lot of energy there in the beginning, and kind of came through. Francis got me at the end, and what I am proud about today, even in the second moto, like I did the best I could the whole time. I made the most out of it, even though I didn't feel great. You're gonna have those days. You know, we're always trying to peak physically on Saturdays every weekend, and sometimes it just doesn't work out. And I think I just trained a little bit too hard this week and just didn't recover in time. And that's just we're still learning. So yeah, it is what it is. Obviously, after coming off 4 wins in a row, third is like not that cool. But at the same time, it was a bad day and I got third. And I think in the past, this probably would have been like a 9th or 10th for me. So I can't complain too bad. Those guys rode great.
You know, I was listening to the live cast, and you could hear Carmichael bring that up, his typical saying, you know, championships are won on the bad day. Good guys put it, like, even a bad day is still a good day. And for you, that's definitely what came around. So
totally. Yeah, and take nothing away, even though I didn't feel great today. Take nothing away from those guys. I mean, they walked away from me in the second moto, and I think they got me, you know, I think I can learn a lot from them. You know, going to go back and watch some film and watch some tape on it, and do what I can to get better. But it wasn't our day, but like you said, third place on, you know, not a good day is not bad at all.
Happy not to cook yourself that first moto like a few of the guys?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, I'm pretty used to the heat, and I think it's one of those deals. I said in the press conference, it's like I almost don't really think it matters too much where you're from. Like, I think some guys are just can deal with the heat and some guys can't, and I feel like I know how to at least manage myself in the heat. Not that I'm like some ultra gnarly guy that's like just wide open 24/7, but I managed myself well and still had some energy in the end of that second moto to go, so it's good.
How was your weekend?
Tough, like I think everybody was tough. The conditions today was extreme, you know. It's in my career, I think was one of the hardest race I rode. Maybe GP of Thailand was a little bit harder, but yeah, it was crazy today. And just finished second overall, but it's not so bad. Struggling with the start all season, and first moto again, bad start, and I have to fight to come back, and yeah, lose a lot of energy, but finish four, and second moto, just get my first good start of the season, and yeah, I show that when I don't have 15 people to pass in the first couple laps, it's help, and won this moto, so it was really good, and I show also that physically we're well prepared with my trainer, and yeah, it's not so bad for sure. I'm a little bit far in point for championship, but yeah, we will fight till the end and see what happens.
I would say, because you guys are SoCal based, so of course the humidity comes as a question. You're very happy with how you felt. I mean, it was miserable, period, but are you happy with how you felt?
Yeah, I think it's not about where you're living, it's about how you prepared, you know, what you did in the winter, what you did in the week, all this run, this cycling session, this gym session, this long moto. So it's just that what makes the difference for me. The condition was just extreme for everybody. We saw even the guy who live in Florida, they're struggling today. So, I mean, it's just who wanted the more and who worked the harder.